The best model is not always the most complicated. Sometimes including variables that are not evidently important can actually reduce the accuracy of predictions. This video accompanies Open Intro Statistics' discussion of model selection, which will help us eliminate variables from the model that are less important. We'll learn about identifying variables in the model that may not be helpful, and we'll discuss two model selection strategies. The model that includes all available explanatory variables is often referred to as the full model. Our goal is to assess whether the full model is the best model. If it isn't, we want to identify a smaller model that is preferable. Here's the output for a regression model relating price of a video game to various features such as con new, an indicator variable for whether the game is new, and stock photo, an indicator variable for whether a stock photo was used in the auction. The last column of the table lists p-values that can be used to assess hypotheses of the following form. The null hypothesis is that beta I equals 0 when the other variables are included in the model. An alternative hypothesis is that beta I is not equal to 0 when the other variables are included in the model. For example, the coefficient of con nu has a t-test statistic of 4.88 and a corresponding p-value of about 0. Therefore, if we keep all the variables in the model and add no others, then there is strong evidence that a game's condition has a real relationship with the total auction price. On the other hand, the t-test statistic for stock photo is 1.02 and the p-value is about 0.31. After accounting for the other predictors, there is not strong evidence that the total auction price is actually related to whether a stock photo was used in the auction. Consequently, we might consider removing the stock photo variable from the model. Two common strategies for adding or removing variables in a multiple regression model are called backward selection and forward selection. These techniques are often referred to as stepwise model selection strategies because they add or delete one variable at a time as they step through the candidate predictors. The backward elimination strategy starts with the model that includes all potential predictor variables. Variables are then eliminated one at a time from the model until only variables with statistically significant p-values remain. The strategy within each elimination step is to drop the variable with the largest p-value, refit the model, and reassess the inclusion of all remaining variables. The forward selection strategy is a reverse of the backward elimination technique. Instead of eliminating variables one at a time, we add variables one at a time until we cannot find any variables that present strong evidence of their importance in the model. Let's apply backward selection to our current example. We start with the full model and eliminate duration since it has the largest p-value. Then, we refit the model, which will give us slightly different p-values for the remaining variables. Since stock photo now has the largest p-value, and that p-value is above 0.05, we drop it from the model. Now, after refitting the model one more time, all of the variables have p-values below 0.05, and we're left with a final model. Before concluding, it is important to note that there is no guarantee that backward elimination and forward selection will arrive at the same final model using p-value or adjusted R-squared methods. If the backwards elimination and forward selection strategies are both tried and they arrive at different models, we generally choose the model with a larger adjusted R-squared as a tiebreaker. In this video, we were introduced to methods for model selection that focus on identifying variables in the model that are most helpful. If you learned something you found interesting, share this video with a friend and visit openintro.org for more resources.